there's a piece of breaking news that is coming in now. CNN News 18 has accessed the FIR in Nizamuddin cluster outbreak case. Of course, this is a case against Maulana Saad of Tablighi Jamaat, who went ahead with this congregation. Why did he go ahead with it? Shouldn't he have called this off, just as his partner who heads the Tablighi Jamaat in Mumbai did that? Couldn't he have informed the cops? Multiple questions being asked. Let's look at... Okay, we are now being joined by Shankar Anand of News 18. Shankar Anand, give me a sense of this FIR. Isme kya kya IPC ke kis dhara ke mutabik ye charge kiya gaya hai?
अगर देखिए मारिया, जिस तरह से अगर बात किया जाए इस एफआईआर की बात करें, तो ये एफआईआर सबसे पहले मैं बताना चाहूंगा न्यूज 18 के पास एक्सक्लूसिव ये आप डॉक्यूमेंट्स आप देख सकते हैं, और इस एफआईआर में कई लोगों के खिलाफ नाम जो है नामजद उनको किया गया है, जिसमें कि डॉक्टर जिशान का नाम है, मुसल्लम सैफी का नाम है, मोहम्मद सलमान का नाम है, यूनुस का नाम है, मुफ्ती शहजाद का नाम है, और इन के साथ साथ जो इसके खिलाफ जो तमाम जो धाराओं की अगर बात करें तो वो काफी संगीन धाराओं के तहत बकायदा मामला दर्ज किया गया है, और इन लोगों को बकायदा हमने कोशिश भी किया गया इन लोगों से बातचीत करने का और इनसे बकायदा इन पे जो आरोप लगे हैं वो जानने का, लेकिन इन तमाम लोगों का मोबाइल फोन भी फिलहाल अभी स्विच ऑफ बताया जा रहा है, और अभी जो पुलिस के हमारे सूत्र बता रहे हैं कि वो अभी फिलहाल कोई भी इन्वेस्टिगेशन इन्हें ज्वाइन नहीं कर रहे हैं और ये फिलहाल फरार बताया जा रहा है, तो लिहाजा इन लोगों को पकड़ने के लिए, इन लोगों को हिरासत में लेने के लिए पुलिस भी बकायदा आगे काम कर रही है, लेकिन जिस तरह से संगीन आरोप की अगर बात करें, जिस तरह से वहां पर एक लापरवाही के मामले को अंजाम दिया गया, जिस तरह से काफी नोटिस देने के बावजूद भी जो स्थानीय पुलिस के द्वारा उन लोगों को पहले से इस मामले में सतर्क किया गया था, उसके बावजूद जो विदेशी लोगों को वहां पर रखा गया और जिसके चलते कोरोना वायरस का संक्रमण हुआ, और यहाँ पर देखते देखते यहाँ पर काफी लोगों को इसका संक्रमण झेलना पड़ा।
And this is also the violation of the visa rules. They came on tourist visas and then they went ahead in indulging in sermons. So certainly there are dereliction of duty on multiple levels. I mean, the violation of rules at multiple levels.
निश्चित तौर पर देखिए महाराज, यहाँ पे कई कानून का उल्लंघन किया गया, चाहे वह वीजा कानून की बात कर ले, इसके साथ साथ कई ऐसे कानून का उल्लंघन किया गया इस मामले में लगातार। जिस तरह से भारतीय प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी भी तमाम लोगों से अपील कर रहे थे कि कहीं भी कोई भी वहां पर इकट्ठा ना हो, और जिस तरह से धारा 144 का हवाला दिया गया, उसके बावजूद यहां पर सैकड़ों नहीं हजारों के तादाद में लोग यहां पर इकट्ठा थे, और जिसके वजह से यहां पर इतना बड़ा एक संक्रमण जो एक जो कोरोना वायरस जो है उसे लड़ने की एक मुहिम जो है उसको कहीं ना कहीं धक्का लगा है, और अभी जो है फिलहाल वो यहाँ से जिस तरह से काफी लोग अब गलत तरीके से यहाँ से मूव भी कर गए हैं, काफी लोग यहाँ से मूवमेंट हुआ है, तो अलग अलग राज्यों में जब लोग मूवमेंट करके जा रहे हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं एक डर ऐसा भी है कि वहां पर भी ये जाकर वहां पर इस बीमारी को फैला सकते हैं, इस वायरस को फैला सकते हैं, तो कहीं ना कहीं वो भी मामला यहाँ पे बनता है।
शंकर आनंद, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस, एंड लेट मी गो स्ट्रेट टू ज़ाका जेकब, हु विल एक्सप्लेन टू अस दिस तबलीकी ट्रेल। ओवर टू यू ज़ाका।
Oh, absolutely. This has become now the single biggest source of worry, source of contention, certainly the source of a cluster outbreak that India has seen. The total number of figures as of right now, 1965. Just at the start of this week, we were at 1,000 cases. Now we're looking at potentially 2,000 cases before the end of the day today. Tablighi trail. Out of the 27 states where there are positive cases, 20 states have been affected. 434 individuals who attended that event, that markaz in Nizamuddin in Delhi, have all tested positive. Remember, 8,400 over a period of 15 days attended that markaz. So 400 odd of them have tested positive. Which are the states that are maximum affected because of that? In Tamil Nadu, and this is a very, very interesting story, because in Tamil Nadu, the total number of infected people is 234, out of which 190 of them, that is more than 75%, attended this markaz that happened in Nizamuddin. They are all in a government hospital facility across the state of Tamil Nadu. Let's go to the neighboring state of Andhra Pradesh. Again, in the neighboring state of Andhra Pradesh, there are in total just 86 cases, 64 of them, more than two-thirds of them, attended this markaz event that happened in Nizamuddin. Let me also go across to the neighboring state of Telangana, and our viewers will remember in Telangana is where this first came up, because five people died and the Telangana administration alerted the Delhi authorities to it. That's when people came to know that there was this huge event and people had to be evacuated. 77 confirmed cases of people with COVID-19 who attended the Nizamuddin event. This is in the state of Telangana. And also about the state of Delhi, where again, the total number of cases in the national capital is 153. 53 of them attended this event. So one third, almost a third of all the cases in the national capital were people who attended this Tablighi Jamaat event. So it gives you a sense of why, you know, the authorities are having such a tough time in trying to decipher where all these people have gone. And remember, these are just people who were in direct contact, who had directly participated in that event. If you were to do contract tracing for 8,400 people who attended that over a 15-day period, you're looking at potentially lakhs and lakhs of people who need to be identified.
And Zaka, this virus has spread also in the Northeast now. And one of them in Arunachal Pradesh has tested positive and he attended the Tablik.
Absolutely, absolutely. In fact, if you look at the map of India, all states, I think with the exception of three states in the Northeast, which happen to be Meghalaya, Nagaland and Tripura, with the exception of just these three states, Sikkim also, four states, all the other states have been infected. Assam has a number of cases as well. Arunachal Pradesh has just added to that list the first case in the state of Arunachal Pradesh. So what we are trying to do with the magic wall is to try and explain to you, the corona wall is to try and explain to you the kind of clusters that are developing. Maharashtra, for example, the Dharavi challenge, which we've been talking about for a number of days now, the first death yesterday, now a second possible case. Maharashtra is the only state in the country which has more than 300 cases so far. And the bad news is 280 of them are still active. They are right now in a hospital or some medical facility right now receiving treatment. That should worry the authorities. And God forbid, if the Dharavi case were to have a spin-off, then you're potentially looking at thousands, if not more than that, potentially being infected because of COVID-19. So this is our attempt to try and explain on a map of India which are the states that are worst affected, which are the states that are slightly better off. If you look at this map, you know, whether it is in the northern Hindi heartland, whether it's in the west, whether it's in the south, across the country, we are having a large chunk, large parts of the country being infected badly because of the coronavirus.
Zaka, before I let you go, a quick word also on Tamil Nadu, because Tamil Nadu was also a state which was seen as a late responder. They responded very late, much after other states. There, 1,500 people attended this Tablik congregation. They went back, and how many are infected?
So right now in the state of Tamil Nadu, we'll go back to the Tablighi filter. In the state of Tamil Nadu, out of the 234 cases in the state, 190 are people who attended the Tablighi event. So that is a large chunk. That is more than 75%, more than three-fourths in the state of Tamil Nadu, which, like you said rightly, Maria, was a late responder. It did not come into the numbers. In fact, this number was way low. It was in the 20s and 30s up until just a couple of days ago. And suddenly, first it was 45 people and then another 40 people. And then eventually yesterday, the total toll of 190 people who have tested positive in this state, all of whom attended that Tablighi event.
Zaka Jacob, thank you so much for getting us the latest and explaining for our viewers in terms of numbers how the cases are stacked up. With schools and colleges shut for an indefinite period of time, both parents and students are turning to virtual classrooms to, in fact, look at all the syllabus. CNN News 18's Zeba Warsi with a special report.
When a scenario like coronavirus has come,
it's a different kind of classroom for Aryan, a class 8 student of DPS Gurgaon.
Laborers, all right.
Uniform on, it's across to the computer, attending online classes arranged by his school. With the coronavirus creating havoc globally, closing down schools, colleges, universities, coaching institutes and other educational institutions, the education sector is adapting to the change. Students of the Indian school are given online assignments. Class 11th and 12th students of the school have a set timetable and use the Zoom app to attend class.
21st century is the time of digital revolution. So during this time of lockdown, the teachers at the Indian school are teaching students with the use of technology. What we are doing is we are uploading videos, worksheets and various projects that the students can do at home. For classes 10th and 12th, the teachers are taking classes with the help of Zoom. And they have a particular timetable that is followed from Monday to Friday for all the subjects.
Online learning that has been taken up by our school is highly effective. We are provided with timetables to help us be more self-disciplined and are also able to interact with our teachers on a daily basis.
I feel that this is a very important step which connects the students to their school and studies. which they were missing out on, and also emphasize on the fact that nothing comes in the way of learning.
Place value chart on one paper.
In Ahmedabad, QMAT teacher Pooja Zakatia Mehta is busier than usual. With the lockdown in force, most students have applied for her online tuitions. She feels the coronavirus lockdown is an opportunity to expand digital learning.
During this lockdown, while the others are looking for activities, we teachers are busy nurturing the kids to prevent any math loss happening during this time.
These books are now being replaced by smartphones, tablets, laptops and computers. India does not have a centralized e-learning platform as of now, but several government e-learning platforms such as Swayam, Deeksha, NCRT, e-textbooks are being extensively used by many schools already. Going forward, the government is mulling over starting the new academic year through digital modules. But the big question remains, what about those students who belong to the economically weaker sections of the society, who don't have access to smartphones or high-speed internet? The government will have to look at that if this continues.
And talking about the Dharavi challenge, this is a cluster outbreak that perhaps could be unfolding. There is a second positive case that has been reported from today. This is Asia's biggest slum and it records first COVID-19 death, and there is first case that have been reported today. 15 lakh people packed into 2.1 kilometer area live there. So any norms of social distancing is unlikely to be followed here. And 73% of inhabitants use community toilets. So again, a possibility of transmission at another level. Average of 4 to 5 people share one room. So in very close quarters they live. It's almost very, very close. In one room, 4 to 5 people. It's very difficult. That's why it's being called another logistical challenge here. No proper boundary walls, difficult to seal is another challenge. How do you seal this Dharavi slum? It's Asia's biggest slum where people are very, very close to each other. There's a piece of breaking news that's coming in now.